on Game Night, Nikki, Aaron, Lincoln, and myself, Dave, are going to play Pandemic Reign of Cthulhu, a cooperative game designed by Chuck D. Yager, based on the game Pandemic by Matt Leacock. It plays 2 to 4 investigators and is published by Z-Man Games. So let's try not to go insane!
Hey, Dave.
Hey, Lincoln.
Will you teach us Pandemic, the Reign of Cthulhu?
Don't say it that way.
Or do.
I'm going to teach you Pandemic Reign of Cthulhu.
Okay.
And then people on the internet can fight over the correct pronunciation.
Okay.
Pandemic Reign of Cthulhu, as you might guess from the first word in that title, is very much like Pandemic.
Right.
Except it's Cthulhu themed. Here's the board.
It's beautiful.
It is everything. The game is gorgeous. Like in Pandemic, we have one way to win. In this case, there are 4 gates that we must seal. And if we seal all 4 gates, we win.
Great.
There are so many ways to lose. One of the ways we lose is if we need to put a cultist on the board and we can't, because there aren't enough available. One of the ways we lose is if we need to put a Shoggoth, is that how it's pronounced, on the board and we can't.
Sure.
Then we lose. One of the ways we lose is if the last old one, this is the track of old ones, Cthulhu being right here as the king old one, if the last old one is revealed, we lose. Another way we can lose is if we all go insane!
Okay.
And then finally, the last way to lose is if there weren't enough, is if we need to, that's why I didn't think of it because it's over here, but if we need to draw cards from the player deck and we can't.
Okay.
And that means at the end of our turns, you're going to draw 2 cards, which is to say if there's 1 card left, that's we lose. 1 card, no. 2nd card, we lose.
Right.
Okay? But 2 cards, draw 2, no cards, we're still okay.
For that turn.
For that turn.
That's it. Yeah.
All right?
We win immediately on that one.
Yeah.
Since we're discussing the player cards, let's talk about the player deck really quick. It's just cards with the 4 towns in them, and each town has 6 locations. The locations aren't on the cards. The card just represents
the turn.
Yeah, there's kind of like a streamlined thing going on here that you'll see because on your turn, let's get to a turn, you have 4 actions that you can spend. One of your actions is you can walk, which is to say you can move from one place, one location to another. All right? Another action is you can take the bus. Conveniently, I've moved myself onto where the bus station is. Each town has 1 bus station.
Okay.
And if you're on that bus station, you can then move for 1 action from that bus station to anywhere else on the board in the following way. If I am in Kingsport, I can play a Kingsport card if I'm on the bus station, and I can move anywhere. If I am in Kingsport and I'm on the bus station and I don't have or don't want to play a Kingsport card, I can move one of the other cards to move to that town. So from Kingsport, I can play this Dunwich card.
To go to Dunwich.
To go to anywhere in Dunwich. Mm. I don't have to go just to the bus station.
Oh, neat. You only have to do that just to be leaving from
Correct.
The bus station.
Correct. You can go to anywhere in that, which is cool. It's a lot easier to move than in Pandemic, which I really like. So that's one of your actions. You can use a gate. Each of these gates that we have yet to seal is a portal that we can use to travel from gate to gate. If you do travel, however, from gate to gate, you must roll the sanity die. There are other times in the board where you, times in the game, sorry, where you must roll the sanity die. And suffice to say, we all start with 4 sanity. If you roll a sanity symbol, you lose one. There's 2 blanks, there's 2 sanity symbols, there's 1 double loss. Yeah. And then there's 1, put 2 cultists on the board. They go in your location, where you happen to be, where your guy happens to be, if you roll that. All right, sanity die. You can defeat a cultist if you are in a space where there is a cultist. For 1 action, you just take him off. That's an action, you remove a cultist. And then finally, you can spend 3 actions to defeat a Shoggoth. It takes 3 actions. It has to, you can't split them up from turn to turn. They don't carry over.
It has to
happen
in 1 turn.
Correct. The thing about a Shoggoth is if you move into a space where there is a Shoggoth, or if the Shoggoth moves into a space where you are, hey Dave, how can that happen? That's coming up later in the rules explanation. you must roll a sanity die.
Yeah, because he's terrifying.
He is super scary.
He kind of really is super scary.
Yeah.
That's really freaky. Little miniature there. All right? And then finally, for an action, you can seal one of the gates. That is what we're trying to do. This will be familiar to you if you played Pandemic. In order to seal Savius' graveyard here in Kingsport, I need 5 Kingsport cards. Mm. The last thing that you can do, one of your actions on your turn, is you can trade cards with another player, basically. It costs 1 action per card, and like in Pandemic, you must both be on the same space of the board. And so if I'm here with someone else, I can trade a Kingsport card. You can only trade or I can take a Kingsport card from that player. You can also trade relic cards. The relic cards I have not gotten to yet, but they are the ones that are shuffled into the deck. They're basically good things they allow you to do. They're like the items in Pandemic? The, do you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah,
like the helicopter
exactly.
And the whatever.
Oh, right, yeah, the special
One Quiet Night and things like that.
Yeah. Right. So, if you're on a spot with another player for an action, you can either give a card to that person or take a card from that person, and it can be a relic card or a card of the town that you are both in.
Okay.
Got it.
Okay. So, those are the 4 actions that you can have, and let me further clarify, because I didn't do this. When you seal a gate, you take the 5 cards and you spend them.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Those cards are discarded, of course, because all the player cards are discarded. They don't go back in the deck to, like, help us out. And you then take a cultist. You remove 1 cultist from every location in that town.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Okay.
So when we close the Kingsport gate, each Kingsport location that has a cultist is 1 fewer. Okay?
Okay.
All right. So after you've taken your actions, you then draw 2 cards. All right? If you draw it mixed into the deck, we're going to split the deck into 4 equal piles after we give each of us our starting hand, which in a 4-player game is 2 cards. And we're going to mix these 4 Evil Stirs cards. These are like the Epidemic cards from Pandemic. On your turn, if one of the cards you draw is one of these Evil Stirs cards, it resolves immediately. The first thing we're going to do is the person whose turn it is rolls the sanity die for stirring up evil. Then there is an awakening, that's what they call it, in which you reveal the next old one, all right? The old ones are going to have negative effects on us. Some will be immediate and just happen. Some will be permanent effects for the rest of the game, all right? Then a Shoggoth appears. We're going to draw the bottom card from the deck, and we're going to put a Shoggoth on that location. That card then goes in the discard pile, and then, as in Pandemic, we will shuffle the discard pile and put it on the top of the deck. And that is Evil Stirs, okay? You do not get another card to replace the Evil Stirs card that you drew. You're only ever drawing 2 cards from that deck. All right? Then, once we do that, we then summon, we draw summoning cards, that's what this deck is called, based on whatever number we are currently at. We are currently here at 2, and then 2, and then 2, and then 2, and then 3, et cetera. And we flip over them 1 at a time, and like in Pandemic, they're going to be, here's the market, and we're going to take a cultist, and we're going to put it in the market. Some of these have a little Shoggoth symbol on them.
Ooh, what's
this
that
one
do?
Does, this one doesn't. When that comes up, all Shoggoths that are on the board will move 1 space closer to the closest open gate. All right?
Okay.
If there is a tie for closest open gate, the person whose turn it is can decide which is the path. This is how a Shoggoth can move into a location where you are.
Mm-hmm.
And when that happens, you need to roll the sanity die.
So if this was the open gate, is this moving towards that?
No, because that's an open gate there. But if that's sealed...
Oh, so the nearest open
the
gate
The nearest
for each
open
guy.
Gate.
Okay.
If that's sealed, though, then this is the nearest
okay.
one.
Okay.
Right.
Right? 1,
yeah.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's clearly the nearest one.
Yeah. Does he have to take the bus?
No bus on the no okay. Shoggoth on the bus. If a Shoggoth is on an open gate,
yeah.
When this symbol comes up and it has to move, it just moves off the board, but that also causes another awakening. We will then flip over the next old one.
Oof.
Okay? Yeah, well, it's not going to be. I mean, considering that there are 4 of these cards in this deck, so 4 of these flip up for sure. All right. Another thing that can cause an awakening is if there are 3 cultists.
Yeah.
And another one needs to come in. It's an outbreak.
Another one needs to come in. What happens is this causes an awakening. This cultist does not go on the board. It just goes back off to the side. Nothing
There's no spread.
Nope. There's no spread like in pandemic. But it does cause an awakening, and we will then flip over another one. I mean, what do we have here? Seven of these?
Right.
Really six, right? Well, because when this one flips, we lose.
Right.
Right?
We've got four evil stirrups.
We've got seven, essentially, because we start at zero. And there's four of them in here. Yeah. So really, we only need that to happen three times.
Yeah.
Or one of these to go off.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. The clock can tick pretty quick.
Yes. All right. We haven't chosen our characters. There are seven different characters, each one with a special ability. I'm not going to explain them all, but the way they are chosen is you shuffle them up, and you put two face up, and whoever the star player is the person who last read a horror story. Ooh. I assume that's you?
Could be Nikki.
When was the last? No? All right.
I don't know. It depends upon what you call a horror story.
You're going to put two up?
The last time you read anything.
If it's close, then yes.
I read Pretty Deadly. But
all right.
Sure.
You're going to put two up. That person's going to choose one of those two. Then the next person gets from the next two, and then the next two, and then the next two. That's easier and quicker than looking at all of them.
Yes.
And figuring it out. If you lose all of your sanity and you go insane, you take your character card and you flip it to the other side. Your special ability on the one side now becomes your insane special ability on the other side. And this little number, this is how many actions you have. You have one fewer action now that you're insane.
Oh.
Okay.
There is a way to cure your insanity. Yes. And that is if you are on a gate and you seal it.
Yes.
Mm. You can then, after you seal that gate, you can...
As a reward.
You flip back over. You immediately move to either the hospital or the church, your choice. And you immediately get one more action because you have...
Oh, cool.
You've gained your extra action. All right? I think there's a relic card in the deck that also helps you to go insane. And I didn't say this, but another thing that happens when you seal a gate is that you draw a relic card to your hand.
Oh.
That's how we get more from the card off to the side. Mm-hmm.
So can you seal a gate if you're insane?
Yeah.
You
totally can. Hmm. The only thing that happens when you're insane is that you have one fewer action and you have a lesser ability.
Okay.
All right? I have not read either of the abilities on our side. I'm waiting to be surprised when we play. The other thing is that a gate, when it is sealed, obviously, can no longer be used for movement. You can no longer move from this gate to this gate at the cost of sanity.
Those are two-sided. What's the other side mean?
This is the Elder Sign side, and it applies to the Elder Sign Relic card, for which I don't know what it is yet because I haven't seen
it. Nice.
I just know that it's in the deck. All right. I think that's everything. So let me set the deck up so we can start, and we'll choose roles, and then we'll play. All right. So we have set up the decks. We have chosen our roles, which we're going to talk about in a second. But we've also figured out things that I've perhaps forgotten, and one of those was that you have a hand limit of seven cards, and if at any point, when you draw cards, or that means someone can't pass you a card and take you over that limit, but if you go above that limit, you have to either discard down to seven or play relic cards to take yourself down to seven. And that brings up another thing that I forgot to mention. I was just going on the assumption of pandemic knowledge, but relic cards, playing a relic card is not an action.
Okay.
And can be done at any time, including on other players' turns. Mm. But remember, when you play a relic card, after you play it, you then must roll a sanity die.
Yeah.
Okay? So, Nikki, who did you choose?
The detective.
Okay, and your power is?
You need only four cards of the same color to seal a gate.
Okay.
I'm the hunter. Remove all cultists when doing the defeat a cultist action. So when I go to town and delete it, they all go.
Oh, nice.
And once per turn, I may defeat a Shoggoth for only one action.
Wow.
Wow, that's pretty good.
I've got the reporter. I can take the bus, discard any clue card to go to any location in any town.
Nice.
So the bus is a magic teleport for me. Or as an action, I can just go from bus station to bus station.
Oh, that's cool.
Without spending a card.
Without a card. Well, that's nice.
Yep.
And I just cheaped out and took the doctor, who has five actions.
Okay.
Sounds good.
I thought, that's not complicated. I'll just take that.
Yeah.
We need to seed the board, however. We haven't done that. And you do it pretty much like you'd expect. We're going to put three cultists, please, in at the Historic Inn.
Three?
Yep. In Dunwich. Please put three cultists in the boardwalk.
Three?
Yep. Two cultists, please, at the cafe. and two cultists at the wharf. Wharf's right there.
Wharf.
Please put one in the woods and one at Farmstead.
Oh, well. Yellow's not
good. Yeah.
And a Shoggoth, please, at the theater.
Oh, boo. Theater. You don't want to see a play.
You want to see a play. Or a movie, I don't know.
All right.
All right.
Here we go. Wow. Right. None of these are near us at all.
No.
No.
And we are at the bus station.
Oh, and just for the sake of argument.
Not. Oh, we are. Yeah, there's two.
That's true.
You lied.
We start on the bus station. And we didn't actually say this, but the game can be played in three difficulty levels, and we're playing at the hardest one.
What?
Yes.
Yeah.
So how does it change? What happens?
You just take out, what are they called? Clue cards.
So they're out of this deck. You take out two.
Thank you.
You
take out two of each color.
For each city.
What? So two yellows, two blues, two reds, two yellows. There's two fewer in there.
Got it.
And in the middle range, the middle difficulty level is one fewer, and the easy one, obviously, as you play with them all. All right, Nikki P, you start us off, and it actually, as a suggestion in the rules, it says they suggest you play with your hand face up.
Okay.
I don't see any reason not to do that.
All right.
That's a lot easier than thematically trying to tell to you in character. Yeah.
That you should head to Argo.
Can I give her cards on my turn?
Take them from you as one of her actions.
If they match the town you're in.
If they match the town you're in.
Yeah, we're not there, so.
Yeah. I was gonna take the bus and to Inn's Mouth, but should I hold on to it is what you're
thinking?
That's
the only thing we actually have a number of.
Okay.
You could give me one. We got to go there, though.
But she can go there right now and take one of those away.
That seems decent.
Granted,
right.
This only matters if the reshuffle comes up.
But it's going to come up at some point.
Yeah. It could be the very top card.
Yeah.
Or I just go, move somewhere in Arkham, because that's my other.
Well, no, you
but
can
there's
use.
There's nothing in Arkham yet.
For sake of argument, you could use this card to go to Innsmouth.
Yes.
That's right, if you use it.
Because you're in Arkham. In.
Oh, yeah. Why don't I do that?
Yeah, why don't you?
Okay.
It means you won't. Before you do that, do we want to give her those Innsmouth cards?
Now, wait a second.
Yeah.
So, couldn't she do this more than once? Play the card to go there?
Yes.
Clean up and then go here directly with her cards?
Yes.
And then we'd be done with those?
She could totally do that.
In other words, that would prepare us right off the bat to like not have an awakening?
Outbreak, yeah. Awakening.
Sure, if you want. It's really up to what you think whether we should be.
But that's only going to happen if evil stirs, right? Because we have these two cards are here in the discards. We know.
True. I like cleaning up.
I do too.
Okay.
I'm a fan of that.
I feel like I personally feel like we have three greens and three blues right now, right?
Yes.
So, let's.
But greens are kind of they're not useless, but.
That's true.
Actually, yeah.
They're useless right now.
They're useless.
Then
let's get five and seal the gate before anything happens there.
All right. I mean, she could go here and just get rid of all of them.
Yes.
That would be her whole turn.
Yes.
What I'm saying is, should we save one color?
I could do that without spending a card because of my bus travels.
Okay. All right, I've put all my input in. Now, whatever you want to do,
so if that's the case, then Aaron, I mean, that's still two other players drawing cards and stuff happening.
Right.
Potentially happening. But he can go here easily, and Nikki could go here
with any card.
Yeah, and then maybe we just reserve the greens for.
Remember, we have this to do with.
Yes,
it's got 1, 2, 3 movement before it gets there, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and that's not four turns necessarily. That's four cards. It has that symbol on it.
Right.
I don't know what the mix is as far as
Lincoln's the fighter guy. Lincoln takes one action to kill that. So
it's all the way here, though.
I know. Yeah. We're at a bus station. Oh, right.
Well, if Aaron's going to go deal
with the train
with
station, though.
This.
Yep.
Seems then like I can it. You can go
burn
here.
My Arkham card and go.
Or your purple one.
No, if it matches the town she's in, she can go anywhere.
Right.
So she can go directly here.
Right. Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
She can use the Arkham card to go anywhere.
Right.
That was my
point. That seems, yeah.
All right, here we go.
What are you going to do?
Taking the bus.
Okay.
Taking the bus
so
to fight
evil. So I
burn
that card.
Yep,
discard. Taking the bus.
That's action one.
Yep.
And action two. Hey, I'm pretty big.
Yeah, you are a lot taller than
those cultists.
Just step on them.
Like Godzilla. Take a cultist out.
That's action two.
And?
My feeling is you might as well just get rid of all of them.
Yeah, I mean, there's not much else to do.
Okay.
I don't want you to spend this card right now.
Agreed.
Just in case we get one more.
Right. Okay. So let's get rid of...
Well, she's the four, too.
So. Oh, right. I fell over.
You lost.
I'm so tired.
All right. Those are your actions.
Yep.
So draw two cards.
Okay. Dun, dun, dun.
Ooh. Hey, a relic.
Book
what is it?
Book of Shadow.
What does it do?
Draw, look at, and rearrange the top four cards of the player deck.
Ooh, the player deck. That could be so
put
good.
Them back on top.
Okay.
Once I do that. Hmm. So that was card one.
Yep.
Card two.
Is Kingsport.
Kingsport.
Okay. So that concludes your drawing. And now we are at two. We draw two summoning cards. Please place a cultist in the train station.
Hey, we're at.
That's easy enough. And, all right, no Shoggoth symbol in the diner. And it's Lincoln's turn. This game's easy.
No problem.
There was no Shoggoth symbol in either one?
Nope.
All right.
Hmm. Yeah, I don't know what the mix is, but it can't be too bad, right?
No, oh, but it can't be too good either.
Well, I guess I can hit... Well, Aaron could potentially go over there and deal with that. Should I just remove this one, then go over here and remove those two?
You get rid of them all with the thing?
Yes.
Why don't you leave that right. one? Why don't you do one... Two, oh, you can't do that one.
But, well, I mean, I can. No, I can't. One, two, three. No, I could. One, two, three, done. And they're done. And then you could leave it for Aaron to do something else.
Sure, and that also leaves you on a bus station.
That's
in case
probably
you want to move someplace.
Why don't, oh, but you could also go.
Yep.
No, you can't. He can't get down here. I was trying to figure out how
I
could take the bus.
No, I don't have the colors. No. Yeah. I wish.
Yeah. You could take this card from me.
Or from me.
And then go 2, 3, 4 to kill this Shoggoth.
Oh. And then you could still do the bus thing because you can just go there.
With
that's a better choice.
Yes, I can just go there.
Yeah, let's do that.
Do that.
All right, okay, so that's so one.
One. Two.
One. Two for the bus movement.
Two
for the
move. Move me here.
No, you can go here if you want.
Oh,
you
yeah.
Oh, that's right.
Anywhere.
Yeah, yeah. And then.
Okay, but going into that space, you have to throw the sanity.
Whoa.
One.
Lose one.
Yeah.
One sanity.
Ah. Bonkers.
For defeating a Shoggoth, you get a relic card.
Sweet.
And you have one more action.
I have the Mego Eye.
What is
it? The next gate requires one fewer clue cards to seal. Put this card next to the player, discard pile, and discard it when the next gate is sealed. So I hold on to it till we do that?
Correct. When a relic card doesn't activate till you play it, and even though it doesn't cost an action, you still have to decide to play it. Because remember, when you play it, you will roll the sanity die.
Okie dokie. So,
you have one more.
Also, move me back to the bus station.
All right.
The market is
at the. And now draw two cards.
Ugh. Draw two cards could be bad.
It's going to be great.
Hey, Arkham. Hey, Innsmouth, we're really close.
Look at that. Well, no, we already could have done it with three since Nikki takes only four cards to seal, and the Mego Eye reduces anything by one. Like, we can seal Innsmouth right now.
Yeah, I just got to get her the cards.
Yeah. Meanwhile, please add a cultist at the hospital.
Hospital.
And at the park. Gate is.
The good thing is I can actually
park.
Go
where
there
the gate
with
is
the
too.
One card I have.
Right?
And then pass them.
That's correct. All right, Aaron.
All right. I'm going to fight these guys, right?
Okay.
That seems to make sense. Since I can travel for no card from bus station to bus station.
Okay.
And then
look at you standing on the
I know.
You're going to take three actions and just do that?
Unless there's somewhere else I need to be. I think I should still be at a bus station. Right?
That makes totally makes sense.
So, yeah. 2, 3, 4.
All right. Draw two cards.
Kingsport and Kingsport.
Mm.
Uh-oh. That means I'm going to draw it.
And two of these.
Please add a cultist at the graveyard.
The graveyard.
Still, by the way, no Shoggoth symbol.
Wow.
And there it is. Thanks for pointing that out.
It's on the board.
I'm teasing, Dave.
That's exciting.
So does that mean one appears there?
Nope.
Then how do they appear?
They will come up through.
So when there's nothing on the board, the symbol does nothing?
Right.
Great.
The Shoggoth symbols only move them once they're on the board.
Great.
Okay.
No, and also remember, one appears when we have an awakening.
Yes.
Okay.
That's the way they get on the board. All right. Well, should I just get rid of stuff?
I suppose.
I don't have cards to necessarily meet anybody.
Right.
What are we at?
We're at 3 orange and 4 blue, to be very thematic.
2 green.
And 2 green and 2 yellow, yeah.
Well, I don't know what to do. Other than I can
guess.
Just get stuff off the board.
Yeah.
I'm going to end my turn with you, I think, just so that we can, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How about if I do this? 1, 2, 3, Four or five.
So we can pass if
just in case. Mm-hmm. In case for whatever reason we need to pass stuff.
Mm-hmm.
All right, here we go. And wow.
Yeah. Ooh.
Look at that all of a sudden.
Yeah.
Okay. And then please put a we're putting a lot of cultists on the board.
Yeah, we are.
No,
and the pawn shop. You know what though? This is good because
yeah, the deck's
they're
be
very
thick.
Spread
the
out.
The deck's going to be thick. And at the docks.
And that was two Shoggoth symbols in a row, just
yeah.
since we were waiting for them.
Well, to now we know they're in there.
All right. Can we seal anything? Where are you? You're over there.
Where is he? He's over there.
I'm
we can't
over there.
Seal anything till we get to you, right? Till we get those cards to
right.
you.
Right.
Is there a teleport function? Can.
Yeah, it's called being a reporter.
You don't have a red...
You know, there's the one where you could...
Lincoln, you don't have a red card, right?
Yeah, the airlift.
Yeah. Not airlift. The one person, the dispatcher
where is
can
it?
Move
it's
people
at the hospital.
Around.
Oh, right.
I can either...
There may be something like that in the game.
Get to Lincoln and give him this.
No, we have to do
we
it in
get
purple.
Them to, we want to get them to you, right?
Or I can
yeah,
get...
Yeah, she could come to you.
Two.
Oh, I see. One, two, three.
Or, no, this is Lincoln.
That's
this
me,
is
yeah. That's what I'm trying to tell you. I'm in the wrong town to exchange that.
Or...
Well, you
Aaron
can move to her
we can
on my turn, but then she can't do it till her turn, but yes. The other good thing is I have a purple card, so I can spend one to get over there and then give her the two remaining, and then we could use the Mego Eye.
You might not even have to, because she might draw one.
Yeah.
Actually, we probably should hold on to the Mego Eye, if at all possible, for, like, something horrible, right?
Yes.
In other words, we have four for this one.
Yeah, yeah.
One, two. Should she just...
Buckle
clean
her
up.
Shoe?
Clean up. Cultus.
Clean up isn't bad.
Yeah.
Although they're all at one. It's not the only, there's no real danger spots really
well, no.
right now.
One of the ways we lose is if there aren't enough of these to put on the board and we have to put them on the board.
So I either try to, I think it's either trying to get to
get,
you guys.
Get near, right?
Or
clean
up cultists.
Or just, yeah.
Wait, well you can do both of those. Why don't you just go 1-2, 1-2, and then you're one space away from him.
Okay.
I mean,
but can I give her purple cards in the red city?
Nope.
Yeah, see, that's the problem.
Yeah.
Nope. So she needs to
so
stay
should
there
I stay in the purple so Lincoln can go to purple on his turn and give me the purple?
I guess so.
It makes sense if that's what we want to do. I mean, look how quickly this changed.
Right.
And
all of a sudden I have all of these Arkham cards. But I mean, we're going to have to do something at some point, so... You could go 1-2 clean up and waste a turn.
Buckle
and just
your shoe.
Stay on the hospital.
No, she should go 1-2 clean up
and
then
move
go
to the
here to where the gate is.
That makes sense.
That kind of makes sense.
So you have to be at the gate to actually seal it?
Of course.
Of course. Okay. Just making sure.
Because if Lincoln's going to move to her,
if
he can go to any city.
Even a good move for Lincoln to do.
Well, I think we should get to as close to closing the first gate as possible as quickly as we can, right?
All right.
Agreed.
So,
we could, even though everything's going to go to crap before
one.
That happens.
So I go
one. You could go to Lincoln and get two cards right now.
No.
No.
Yes. 1-2. Oh, because you can't trade.
You have to
the,
transfer the town you're in.
So down. All right, never mind. All right.
In his mouth.
One.
Yes. Two.
Three.
Three. And then... Four at the gate, right?
I believe
Do
that.
Do I have to roll a sanity?
No, only for Sean.
I could get to Nikki by the gate.
Oh, so. That's true. He could jump through the gate. Well, the gate's here.
Oh, right.
Of course, I'm already down to three.
And the gate's too far away.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. I forget. We got to remember gate
right.
movement.
Draw two.
Okay.
Here we go.
There are
nice
ways
there.
To move.
There it is.
Wow.
Evil
stirs. Just a roll a die.
Evil right. stirs.
First thing you do is you roll this sanity
okay.
die. Oh,
no.
Hey, we didn't think this out.
Hey, all right.
To go where she is.
Sweet.
That's fine.
Next, there's an awakening. Reveal the first old one.
Dun, dun, dun.
All right, Aaron, you're in charge of reading the old ones because I don't know how to pronounce any of these.
I've always said Yog-Sothoth for this one, but I think it might be Yog-Sothoth.
This little infinity symbol means it's a permanent problem. Go ahead.
We'll just call him Yog.
Playing
he likes
cards
that.
Can only be done by the active player.
Ah.
Eek.
So now they can no longer be played out of turn.
Right. So
that's
he
actually
can't
not
use...
that's actually not too bad.
It's not.
As bad things
can
go.
Can he pass? You can't can you pass the relic card? Yes,
yeah, of
you
course.
Can. Okay.
You just can't play it. Remember I said you could play it out of turn on anyone else's turn? Not any longer. Alright, now we draw the bottom card from the deck and we put a Shoggoth in the junkyard, please.
Eek.
It's a good place.
What has happened?
That goes here.
Yeah, I told you everything was gonna go to crap real
And now
quick.
We shuffle the discards. And let's hope we don't get the hospital.
Right off the bat. Where somebody will probably go insane. Also known as a detective.
All right. Note, if you have to roll the die, don't end on a spot that has any cultists.
Well, no, just don't roll that. Don't roll two cultists.
Yeah,
the,
but
the one out of six?
Too. That's right. Yeah.
All right, now we're done. Now you may draw your second card.
I don't want to.
Wait,
I don't
think that goes over there.
Oh, wait, that's not it.
Oh, no, that comes out.
You don't do it yet?
Nope.
You do it at the normal time.
You would just draw summoning cards the normal time. Ooh, a relic.
A relic.
Wow, that's a lot of relics already.
Somebody's flame.
Al has red.
You may remove up to four cultists or one Shoggoth from anywhere on the board.
Do we want to play that now? Because she's got three. Can we do it before the...
Yes. There are some relic cards that cannot be played during this phase because they refer to, say, the action phase, which we're no longer in.
Okay.
But the general rule of a relic card is it can be played at any time on any player's turn. The fact that we're penalized almost means we should consider playing it now because
otherwise...
it's technically Nikki's turn, and that might...
Yeah, might not come into play till her turn again.
The question is, do we want to get rid of four cultists or do we want to get rid of the Shoggoth?
Right.
It's one or the other.
Yeah.
Well, she... Oh, it's one or the other.
One or the other.
Okay.
And we don't. Wait. And if, as long as the symbols don't come up, that's going to stay there.
But we almost want the symbols to come up because it's going to move here and then here, where Lincoln's going to be there to kill it. It's going to move towards you and make it easier for you to kill it. It's, assuming you're still going to go here and hand her cards, right?
Right.
That makes sense.
So I say kill the cultists, not the Shoggoth.
Okay.
Kill the cultists.
See, but the problem is I can't. How do I get there? I only have three.
You use an Innsmouth card to go to Innsmouth.
Oh, right.
I know that, but then we have three. And
no,
I can only
four.
Use...
four.
No.
I have to spend one to do that.
When to get there.
We have to use the relic to do it. Because she didn't draw one.
Right. Well, she hasn't... Oh, did she do two cards yet?
Yeah,
that was
one
her second card.
One of them was my Eagle Stores, and then this relic is...
Okay.
Well, if you draw another blue one on your turn, then she can take it from you on her turn if we
don't
want to use the eye.
That's true. We might get lucky.
But I still say...
Oh, she can take the... Can I give her the Mego?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, you can trade that too.
Yeah.
Or, Lincoln, you can just go one, two...
But can she take a relic from
yes.
me?
Yes.
Yeah.
You can do
you
that.
You can give
no
or take
what.
A relic or give or take a card.
Okay, cool.
It's an action, though.
Well, and Nikki also has that book, that lets
Shadow.
Her rearrange the top four cards.
On the
so
player
So if
deck?
She did that, she could at least try to ensure that Lincoln or her... Yeah, Lincoln
gets
a blue
one. One of us gets an Innsmouth card, in other words, right?
Well, if it's a top four cards, one of us is going to get it anyway. She should
it's
put
on
it on the top
deck.
Two for
oh,
you to
I
get
see.
It.
Right.
If we wanted to.
Assuming that one of the top four.
There's only nine in the deck, and we have four of them here already.
Oh.
Only nine Innsmouths in the deck?
Because we threw out two.
But the odds are good of any random four cards.
We haven't
cards,
used one
there
to
will
travel.
Be one.
That deck's pretty big.
Yeah.
No, that doesn't change the odds.
Yeah.
It's still...
It doesn't change the odds, but they may not be there.
Well, maybe we should just get rid of cultists, not worry too much about getting Lincoln to Nikki on the very next turn. It can certainly happen by Nikki's next turn.
Oh, I don't know. Sooner.
Oh, Dave.
Yes, you're right.
The same argument we always
no, he's
have.
Right.
Or
it
same
can.
Discussion we always
even
have.
If even if there's no blue cards, we could close that gate on the next turn.
One.
Right?
Two. You could get to Nikki by traveling to here with your Arkham card.
Yeah. And then walking.
Two. You'd have to roll the die. Three, four. You could do that.
But then I can't.
He can't give me any cards.
I won't be giving her any cards.
No,
that's
then
my
she,
four actions.
It's only one to seal it, but she's not going to seal it till her turn anyway. She can take them from you.
Each card's an action.
I know.
Yeah.
She doesn't have enough actions to do that.
Yes, right. She does.
One, two, three. Oh, you're right. One, two, three, seal.
Yeah.
We could
it
do
could
that.
It could be done. But I don't like that inefficient movement.
It gets in there without wasting
true.
An Innsmouth card. That's all I was saying.
But it also costs him three actions.
I would agree.
But what else is he going to do with those actions if there's no more cultists there?
Move somewhere else.
Well,
she should kill the Shoggoth because Lincoln can kill these guys with a single action when he gets there next turn, right?
Well, remember,
if I can get there,
her turn's not over yet.
I
you have to turn two of these
all
cards
right,
over.
I know. That's what you do in this game. You make a plan, and then it goes down the drain.
All right, Nikki, what do you want to do?
Boy. So rearranging has been thrown out the window.
Nope.
That's up to you.
If you want to do it, remember, every time you play a relic card, you also have to roll
the
insanity.
Oh, well.
Which could cultist the hospital right away.
Sweet.
I don't think you should play. Well, it can happen anyway. It could be right now. Right?
Yes, it could.
Let's just do the.
The odds
flame.
Of it happening are so slim.
Flame.
Okay, but you do need to roll.
You also have to roll the sanity die.
And
well,
that could come up still.
You do it. She does her thing first. You play the card, then you roll the die.
Okay. Yeah.
So these guys get cleaned up, plus another one from somewhere.
We're cleaning these up with a relic and a sanity die roll, even though it'll cost Lincoln one action?
He can't get there.
Well, I mean, I could.
He can by spending one of the blue cards.
One, two.
All Once right. we seal the blue gate, the blue cards are not that valuable anymore. Let's do it while we can.
Well, you still need to clean up cultists.
I'm with Aaron now.
Okay.
Okay.
So let's not play any of them and just see what
yes.
happens? Is that what
let's
you're
not, right, let's not risk it.
Are you okay with that?
You guys are insane.
Not yet! Not yet! We will be soon!
I know.
Listen,
all right.
Hey, listen, it's your turn.
Yeah.
You do it the way you want to do it.
Yeah, that's right.
You've heard
all the arguments.
What do you want to do?
I want to see this mess happen.
All right, here we go. Like it's our fault.
Here we go.
Yep.
Come on, hospital card one.
Nope. Historic end?
This moves.
I think that's good. Where's the historic
inn?
It's over here.
It's right here. Oh, it's right where there. We are.
That's nice.
And, oh, the pawn shop.
Oh!
Oh, and hey.
Look at that. He came right to you.
She's got a roll, correct?
Roll the sand. Oh.
Yes. And I got to roll it. Oh, come on!
Six!
Why'd you do that?
Six! Okay, wait. Nope, they don't go on the board.
Both of them don't?
Neither of them go on the board.
All right.
Once there's three, they're just three. Because you can't go more than
three.
But they trigger an awakening.
Oh. See you guys.
Turn over the next whatever.
What's this one?
Chardonnay?
Oof. Okay, all players collectively lose 3, 4, 5 sanity tokens. So with 2, 3, 4. So we lose 5 sanity tokens. Ugh. I am not losing 2. Oof.
Okay.
I can lose 2.
You can?
I think my insane ability is pretty good since I
You know
at
what?
It.
I can lose 2 as well, Lincoln. Why don't you keep one?
Oh,
since
really?
He's going to fight a lot
You're
of
You're
going to
fight a lot of Shoggoths and you need them. So I'll lose 2 as well.
Oh, okay.
And Nikki, you lose 1. Right. I haven't looked on my other side, but I'm pretty sure instead of 5, I just have 4.
Oh, really?
I think my insane thing is you just have 4.
I bet it's something else, too.
How about if I just look?
I guess I should look, too. I mean, I bet it's not supposed
yeah,
to be
Yeah, it's part of up to 4 actions.
Okay.
So I literally just lose
it. Just become... It no, it's part of the strategy. You gotta know.
Okay, let me look into what mine is, then.
What is it?
Each turn, the first time you enter a location with no cultists, roll a die on any sanity loss result, place one cultist instead, ignore all the results.
You got a bad one.
All cultists when doing the defeated cultist action.
So you still kill
I
all
get
the
rid
cultists.
Of the Shoggoth, but I still can get rid of the cultists.
Right. You can also add cultists, which is not great.
But it has to have none.
Right.
Okay.
Okay.
So it's my turn, right?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And first thing we want to do is we want to get me into Innsmouth. So I'm going to spend one of these.
To go to where Nikki is?
Yes.
So roll the die.
To go to the very busy hospital.
Try not to roll the two cultists.
Do I roll twice? Because once I remove the Shoggoth? Oh, no, it doesn't.
No,
I don't have to roll for
every
that.
Time you enter a space or it enters your space, you have to...
Yeah, blank space.
There are blank spaces.
Finally, so that's gone.
That's action one.
Yep.
That was action one.
Two, you're going to defeat it?
It's gone, yep.
Two, you're going to defeat it?
Yep. And three that
Hold on, you get a relic for that?
Oh, okay. Alien carving. The active player can take 3 extra actions this turn.
Oh.
So we can save that or do it whenever, it's whenever we do it.
Right.
But it's going to be me because we have to play for ourselves here.
Right, you have 2 more actions.
I'm going to get rid of all the cultists.
Hang on, it's going to take 2 actions to get her those cards. Do you want to spend both of them to give her those cards?
Well, can I
give
her one?
Yes.
Can I give her one and get rid of those
and
she can take the other one?
Okay. I agree. I'm just saying, one.
Dave likes to present you with all your options.
I'm giving you the rules.
There's a terrible one.
Yeah. Okay.
Hey, that's clean.
Hey, look at that.
4
it's
actions.
Nice and clean.
Go ahead and draw 2 cards.
Okay. Hey, another Innsmouth card.
Yes.
I told you were going to draw one.
That's
I knew
crazy.
It.
Hey, and a rewarded box. No sanity required to play this card. Until the end of your next turn, players do not need sanity rolls.
Ooh.
This is going to be good. Place this card in front of you as a reminder.
When you play it.
Yeah.
Right. In other words, in theory, this is in your hand, right?
Right.
We're playing them up. Remember, you also have a 7 card limit.
I was just going to say,
Well, she's going to take 2 of these.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and she can take 2 of them, because that takes her only to 7.
Right.
So I draw one more card, correct?
No, you just drew 2.
Oh, no, I did. I got an insult.
Yeah, you got
correct.
An insult.
Sweet.
And we
Thank
flip
goodness.
Over 2 cards, please. Hey, another Shoggoth symbol, not that it matters. In the woods.
The woods.
And 1 in the graveyard.
The graveyard. Oof. Oh, yeah. Kingsport's getting messy.
All right, Aaron.
Well, what should I do?
What do you want to do? Do we need to trade cards in any way, you and me?
It doesn't,
seem like it.
It seems like this is our lowest priority because we have 2 yellow cards still.
Right.
The yellow cards are going to come later.
Not only that, but nothing. Well, There's only these two locations, as far as I remember, in the deck.
Correct.
So until we yank a Shoggoth there, we're in good shape.
Right. So...
I like it. I think we should each use these yellow cards to get out of here.
Right.
I don't need to use yellow cards.
Oh, that's right.
I could go one...
Oh, you go bus station to bus station?
With a zero, with no cards at all. With any card, I can go anywhere I want.
You think we should just start doing cleanup?
Yes, I think there. I mean,
particularly in our.
You should go here anyway because.
Well, you have two.
You might draw some Kingsports, and if I draw some, I could follow you.
I agree.
All right. Do what you want.
Which space should I not clean up?
Or start to clean up? Well, we just did the graveyard and the woods.
The woods.
But if the relic card comes up, this is pretty thin. So maybe we should do the graveyard.
Not the relic, but the.
Evil stirs.
All right, so.
Yeah, I think you should take care of those two. Aren't those the ones that just came, right? Is that what?
Oh no, no, those are the two that are not dangerous.
I can get to that one.
Okay.
None of them are dangerous yet. Even if it reshuffles, we're only adding one, right? Me?
Yeah.
I have five actions. I can just walk there.
Oh, okay.
It's a long way.
One, two, three, four.
To move.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Yeah.
So I'm trying to save these cards.
Of course.
At some point, we're going to need cards.
Yeah. But we also, if they can save us like three actions, I think it's worth doing it.
So I can just teleport there. I can go to the woods.
All right.
If you want to go to the graveyard.
I think I need to go to the graveyard. The wharf is not in here right now.
Okay.
So I think I
need to... Well, you're going to the market anyway, right?
Right.
One.
One, two, three, and clean one from the graveyard?
Sure.
Seems like the safest bet to me right now.
Well, or one, two, three, four.
I don't think that's dangerous. I think the graveyard we need to protect. I need to get some off the graveyard and you need to get
some
off the woods.
Remember, a third one there is okay. It's just the fourth one there is bad for us.
Right.
Anyway, because the wharf hasn't come up yet, right?
No.
Which means it could come up next. I'm thinking one, two,
three, four.
Yeah.
Okay.
There we go.
Okay.
Because if I can get you cards, then you're there.
Dunwich.
All right, here comes the yellows.
And Dunwich, they are. I just left there.
Okay, that's fine.
That's all right.
And
we're in good shape. We're going to close all these
cafe
gates right now.
Look at that. We're going to need to go to Dunwich at some point.
Cafe.
And the theater in
the theater.
All right. All right, so I am going to use a Dunwich card, I think, right? I think I'm going to teleport here.
There's not teleport, you're taking the bus.
take a bus here, one, two, three, and then just go 4, 5 and be in the same spot as you. So we can do card switchy-switchy if we need to.
How can you teleport there?
With the bus, with the Dunwich card.
Then that would get you to Dunwich, right?
No, I'm in Dunwich, which means I can go from there to anywhere.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that is a little confusing.
It is, right?
It's kind of not. If you're in the city you have the bus station for, then you take the bus from Dunwich to anywhere.
Okay.
Think of it that way. If you're on a bus station, you can go here. If you're on a bus station, you can go to any color of your cards.
Right.
But there's no reason to go to Dunwich because you're in it.
Right.
So you use that to go.
For some reason, I can't remember both of those at the same time. All right. So where are you going to go to the woods?
Shouldn't I?
I guess so, yeah.
I feel like that's our current problem area. And you guys don't want me to take the long walk, so.
I guess more yellow's coming up, but of course, you know.
All right, well then, should I save it? Because I could give Aaron my yellow.
And I could get there on my turn if I needed to, through the gate.
What do you guys think?
Through the gate,
to close it up with your Migo eye, or you'd have, no, you can't use that when it's not your turn right now.
I mean, should I go to Arkham? I have drawn all these Arkham cards.
No, I'll stick with your plan.
Yeah.
Go I could go one, yeah. two, three, four, five, and end on the bus station.
No, go look. There's a lot of red cards here. There's no green cards in there, or there's one.
Okay. Yes?
Stick with
sure,
that.
Sure.
Sure, right. Yeah. We got
to
do it.
I'm going to use that to go here.
All right.
That's okay. One. Two, three.
Yep.
And then I think 4, 5 is better than
I think so.
Down here to pick stuff up.
Then we can, again,
on the off chance
now we got
that
two turns to reassess and
flip them.
Everything to go to crap.
A card that will hopefully be useless soon.
No,
although it's good for traveling.
And it's good.
Hey, and a card that maybe I could give to you.
Yeah.
Okay.
And please put a cultist in the docks.
In the docks.
In the
right
docks. There. And a cultist in the secret lodge.
The secret lodge.
Uh-oh. Is this Twin Peaks? What is the name of that lodge?
The Silver Twilight Lodge.
No, I'm kidding.
That's impressive that you remember that. All right, Nikki P.
Yep.
Here we go.
All right.
All right, what's your plan?
I would like some cards.
Yes,
from
you would.
A Lincoln.
Okay, so one, two of your actions, boom.
Actually, yeah. Three, right?
No.
Oh, she only needs two. She
one action for each
thing.
Card.
She should not use
I thought
this
she
card.
Was going to take the other one.
No,
she
shouldn't.
No,
I
you're right.
It.
She shouldn't.
One, two.
One, two. And,
you
and
are
now
not
I'm going to seal a gate.
Seal a gate!
With the four.
Okay.
If we're both on that location, do we get to heal? No, I'm checking.
No, if you were
it's ins- only if you're totally insane.
If yeah, you're okay. Insane. For sealing a gate,
remove
one cultist from each city within that.
Oh,
each location in that town.
Okay. Nice.
And believe it or not, that's the only benefit.
That's it? She doesn't get a relic or anything?
Wow, really?
Yeah. Hey, it's pretty good.
You're one quarter of the way to the game. And, yeah. And if she did this gate, for example, one from each town would be huge, right?
Yeah.
That would be a lot of them.
Yeah.
One
yeah.
from each location.
Yes.
You have one more action.
All right.
As crazy as that sounds.
I don't know.
Do you guys want to trade any relic cards before for your last action? Are there any ones that are better in someone's hand over the other?
I don't think so.
Especially because remember, we can't
play
them.
All, it'd be nice if we were
actually,
given to you guys. Because
I think you should give her the Mego Eye because
why?
If anyone's going to use it at some point, it's probably
because,
better for her.
Yeah, okay. That's true.
You,
so
have,
that's
you both
my
have one
action.
Card
as your fourth action.
Yeah. Yep.
But yeah, like then now whatever's next is she can close it with three, right?
Yes. She will need to play a relic card at some point though because her hand limit is getting up there.
Yeah.
Well, it's four right now. She's fine.
But remember, she needs less to
right.
seal the gates too. So that at least she doesn't have to have as much.
Right, but she needs four to seal the gate and technically
now she needs three if she
only if she plays the card.
Okay. But she doesn't have to hold four clue cards to do it for sure.
Draw two.
All right. Done which. And Kingsport.
Nice. That works
well,
nicely.
There we go. We could do Kingsport coming up. Please put a cultist at the boardwalk.
At the boardwalk.
And at the diner.
At the diner.
Is that where, can I get cherry pie there?
Yeah. Mm.
So this is the one difference, right, from Pandemic, which is there's no, like, cure this thing so that these never come up in this town.
Again. Right, or they even become easier, which they do in Pandemic.
Right.
All right.
All right, Lincoln.
Okay.
Now what?
What's
seriously.
The plan now?
So I can't travel through the gate because it's closed now.
Correct.
Book of Shadow, Flame. We haven't used this yet, right?
Nope.
This
no, we haven't used
flame.
Anything because we didn't want to roll the die.
Right.
I kind of feel. Maybe I'm wrong, but I kind of feel like you should take that card from her.
I can't. Oh, I mean now on my turn?
Yeah, because you're in the same place.
Okay.
Or
why?
I'm worried about her hand.
Okay, but then he's
I'm restricted.
He should take any card besides that one, because that's the fight a bunch of stuff cards, and he's already good at that.
No, I care what you're saying.
Not the flame. The flame is not
good. The Book of Shadows, rearrange the top
sure,
of the deck?
Sure, if you really want her to thin out her hand, then yes.
Or she should just maybe play one. I mean, obviously, every time you play one, you have to roll the die, but...
Right, and we've seen how Nikki does with that.
Well, it's just going to be cultists. She won't go insane.
Right, that's true.
I'm only bringing it up now because they happen to be in the same location.
You're right. It's
so
a good
it's
opportunity. Yep.
We do want to feed
her cards.
I wish she had
more of these so that we could...
Well,
but
I have
it's
those.
Better to give those to her anyway. Well, whatever you think on that.
The Book of Shadow?
Because there's not a lot for us to do.
Right.
Well, that'll eat up one of your...
Actions, that's fine.
Actions.
I mean, that's what I'm saying. There's not a lot for me to do.
Now, that's just rearranging these
Right. But
top.
It's like when we need to fish for a perfect fifth card or whatever,
okay.
It helps.
So
okay, so one action.
All right, and then I guess you go
towards
kill
Arkham.
Some stuff. Go towards Arkham, yeah.
Yep. So 2, 3, 4?
I think so.
Yeah, I'm standing on the cultist.
But you could get rid of those, right? If you don't take that card from her.
If he doesn't take it.
What do you guys think? Maybe I'm wrong. Or we could just start playing them.
I say no. I think we're okay.
I think holding
Look,
off.
This
on
deck
that
is starting to get fairly thick. There's not that many green cards in there.
All right,
I think we can wait a little while.
Hey, get ready for another thing. Bizarre statue.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Skip the next summoning step. Do not flip over any summoning cards. That's nice.
That's a really nice. That's the quiet knight.
Yes. Remember now, it can only be played on Lincoln's turn.
Yes.
Okay.
Right.
One more.
Because of this bad guy, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, the very first one we flipped.
The very first one, the last one.
Evil.
Oh, evil stirs. Roll the die.
Stirs.
Stir.
First things first. Oh, thank God you didn't roll the... Yeah. Try not to end... All right. What else? I keep forgetting. Try not to end on places where... all right. Reveal the next old one, right?
Yep.
Dagon. That one's easy to pronounce.
Doggone Dagon.
Place one cultist on each gate location.
Ugh.
Boom.
And it doesn't say open gate, so I would assume that that one Boom. Gets one too.
Nikki can maybe deal with it.
What?
There.
Boom.
There.
Okay. Great. Luckily, it's your turn. And then we do this. A Shoggoth goes in the market. Oof. Then all of these get shuffled.
Whee!
And now we have to decide whether Lincoln wants to play his relic or not.
Right. Since he can only play it on his turn.
The bizarre statue one?
It's. I mean, he might want to play it now. Although he's also at 2 sanity, which is not great.
Considering I seem to lose a sanity every time I roll. No, I blanked that one time.
Wait, why don't you play both the one that cancels all sanity loss and then the other one?
That's a good idea. But I have to roll one for that one, and then I can do the other one without
No, I don't
it.
Think you do.
What does it say?
No, not that
box.
One.
No sanity roll. Oh, we're required to play this card.
And what does it do again?
I don't have to roll sanity, and nobody else does either.
For a full
for
turn.
For a full round.
Oh, do that, because one of us is going to...
It's going to go fight that.
Yeah, right. Totally.
Okay, so...
More importantly, if it moves into us.
Right.
Oh, do that, totally.
Totally.
So, warded box.
Great idea, Aaron. Hey, yeah, nice job.
No sanity.
And then we're going to play the bizarre statue, so we skip the summoning step.
Do you want to play any other ones? You might as well right now while you don't have to roll, right?
There's no sanity. Yeah. What else do you want to do?
Do you want to take 3 more actions?
On
you
could this go turn, do I
boom,
get it?
Boom, boom. Well, no. Oh, that's the
no,
one that you said
we're
you
not
can't.
In the action right. phase anymore.
Right. That's the one. You, but, yeah.
He we're not going to look at the top. We just had that flip, so it doesn't matter. It
well,
doesn't,
hang on. Aaron's about to draw next.
You could
kind of give him yellow.
Feed me yellow.
He needs 2, though.
A yellow or a green, because he
or
can,
a green to give to Dave.
He can give me the green.
Okay.
It's, I say do it as since there's no sanity.
There's no
loss, right?
Yeah, I mean, it's it might not time, be the best time to do it, but.
I think it's definitely the best time. So 2 of them are going to me and 2 of them are going to
Dave.
Right. Hey,
sweet. Okay, so we give 2 to you and then Dave gets those.
Oh, that's perfect. Okay. Yeah.
Done.
That's great.
Well, okay.
So it was 2 yellow, a red, and a green.
Oh.
Yeah, so you're getting a red and a green.
Oh, nice. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right, that'll take me to 7.
Okay.
You might need to
Are you
that
done,
stuff.
Lincoln?
Yeah.
Did you
and
get
we're
all
not,
your
we
stuff?
Don't do a summoning phase, yes.
Wait, did you play the don't do the summoning phase as well?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, that's
we'll
awesome.
We'll do it after your turn.
Yes. Yes.
But that by then, things will be fixed.
Up a little bit.
That's
all right, Aaron, it's your turn.
Okay. So, since we happen to know that I'm going to draw 2 yellow cards at the end of the turn, it's actually pretty easy for me to get here. Because there's a gate right here.
Okay.
Okay. So
you're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 and get rid of the graveyard stuff? And leave this for me?
I think so.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's fine.
That makes sense.
I have extra actions anyway. That's totally fine.
Unless it happens to move onto your space when I do that.
Well, even if it does, it doesn't matter.
Or
that's 1 fewer action I have to spend to get rid of it. Now it's where I
am. Oh, right. And it doesn't cause
but
any
you
sanity
lose,
loss.
You could lose a...
Where are you going?
Oh, he doesn't have to roll.
No.
I guess you're going to Arkham?
I have no idea. Obviously, since I'm clearly about to draw
End of
them.
My next turn, so I actually get
Oh, nice.
No sanity rolls as
Good.
Well on my turn.
Okay.
Well, here's the deal. I'm in Kingsport, so I can go anywhere because I can take
I'll put
the dust.
Here's what we should do is Once we should you stick it on the player when we do that.
Okay.
So, yeah,
you
that's
know what
a
I'm
good
saying?
Idea.
Yep. I feel like just go to the graveyard and get rid of it.
Reporter killing some cultists.
So that's 1, 2, 3, 4.
1, 2, 3, 4.
All right.
Gosh, we still need to look at that. I mean, that's getting.
Yeah, it's
that was
getting
I know. At one point.
Yeah,
there.
It was. Yeah.
Draw 2 cards.
They can, I wonder what that'd be.
I don't know.
I hope it's
Oh my gosh, they're yellow.
Yay.
What?
Now I'm at 7.
Who knew? Summoning?
5. Green.
Diner.
Oof.
Ooh.
No, that's good. That's where Lincoln is.
Yeah.
That's
actually good.
Yeah.
And the cafe. And look, we didn't even need to worry about the summoning.
It's lunch break.
We didn't even need to worry about the summoning phase. Not a Shoggoth on the card, and neither.
That's all right.
I'm happy we played it.
I think it was a smart move.
I'm happy we played it too. Okay. 1.
No sanity roll.
No sanity roll. Thank you, Lincoln.
Yeah.
2, 3, 4. And I get a relic. My first one.
All right.
The Song of Kadoth. No sanity roll required to play this card. Choose 1. All players regain 1 sanity token, Ooh. Or one player regains full sanity. Oh. Mm.
Okay, definitely don't do that now, though.
No, well, remember, no. I can't do it on anyone else's right. turn.
But my point is that it's, why waste one where you don't right. have to roll a sanity at this point in time? Save it.
He's right. I agree, but...
It doesn't make any difference. It doesn't make a waste of sanity.
We don't all need a sanity, right?
We
I
don't,
can just
really.
Give everybody one right now.
No. Save it until Lincoln goes well, to zero. Yeah. Or
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to have to discard if I don't play it.
No, you have 7.
At the end of your next turn.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I need to draw one more.
Yeah, yeah you're right. At 7,
I apologize.
Be fine.
And, hey, Arkham.
Yeah, you should know that one, right?
I know.
Yeah, you should.
All right, you're saying don't play it. I'll say
I say don't play it.
So wait a second. Me.
Yes.
You still have one more card to draw.
Nope.
No.
This was a, this
oh, you're
was
right.
a relic.
He's right. That's my point. Oh. That is my point. I knew there oh. was a reason for that. I will have to throw away a card. Now, I'm happy to do it. I could get rid of this Innsmouth card.
You could, which is only useful for travel.
Or I could just give everybody a sanity now.
Just give everybody a sanity. Right. Either way, it's the same.
Yeah.
Now or later.
I don't think taking
right.
someone back to full sanity is going to matter
okay.
as much. Right?
I'll remind you that you said that.
All right.
Yeah. Fair enough. Now we're going to lose the game.
Everybody take a sanity back.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you.
And now I get to draw 2 cards.
Yes, I was going to say, because you did not get the other card.
You were right.
Right.
It was,
I,
one
like,
was
I didn't
the
see
relic
that card
that.
In the deck.
Actually,
yeah.
hang on, please.
Oh, no.
Hang on.
You're going to back up
it
all the way.
It was 1, 2, 3, 4.
Uh-huh.
I have one more action still.
Oh, he's got 5 actions.
I have one more action still.
Oh, you could get rid of a card that way.
You're right.
We could take everything back if you want.
Let's do it.
Because you could go someplace else.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because I am going to use...
Because you might as well... You use the
I'm
going to
use this Kingsport card.
Yeah, to go anywhere you want.
And I am going to go to the... Where's
somewhere
the gate over here?
It's right here, which is also...
No, the gate's
oh,
here.
There.
I'm going
to
go...
To the cafe.
The cafe's not too
And you don't have to roll when you use the gate this turn.
Well, it doesn't matter. I'm just using the bus. But I know what you're saying.
Okay, I thought you were using the gate.
I'm trying to figure out if I should go right to the gate... Lincoln, you're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4?
Probably, yeah. I won't be able to give you that card, though. You have to get it yourself.
But I can get it on my turn,
yes.
right? So I'm going to go here for my fifth action.
Okay. And okay. You spent the card.
Yes. And now I'm going to draw 2 cards.
Got it.
Hey, okay. Luke Arkham. And
Kingsport.
Oh, okay.
And
I'm psychic.
Historic Inn, where Lincoln is. Brum, 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 brum.
No, he's not there.
No, it's not that.
No.
Oh, you're right, Historic Inn.
This is the cafe.
I'm sorry, I knew it was a bus station. I knew it was a bus station.
Diner, but...
Shoggoth, doesn't matter. And Secret Lodge.
Secret Lodge. Ooh. But that's great.
That yeah, is
great.
We'll be cleaning up, hopefully.
If you, as
Wait,
long as we make
it's
it.
It's still then. 2. Okay, phew. We haven't got to 3
oh,
yet.
I know. Yeah, so that's
right,
going to be, that's when it starts tipping
sure.
bad.
I can I can use my relic card to remove 4 card cultists.
Does it have to be where she is or anywhere?
It doesn't say. You may remove up to 4 cultists or 1 Shoggoth from anywhere on the board.
Wow.
Wow.
Should we just do it?
Well, look at the pile. There's only 7 over there. Not that that's... But still, they come out with every flip.
There's only this, you mean? Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Sure.
They also come out when you roll the die sometimes.
Well, okay, do it.
Oh,
so is that an action?
Yeah, Nikki might
you might as well do it. It's not everything's not costing
right.
a sanity.
And
right.
that's not an action anyway. Right?
It isn't. Should
no.
I wait then?
No, do it.
And move
I'd
around.
Say, I'd say
okay.
No, I would say do it.
So there's that.
So which ones?
I was thinking like these 3 and 1 from here, or
no.
I can get you the card on your turn if I don't have to do those things. Dude.
Did the diner card come out? It did.
Yeah.
So and the secret lodge just came out. So not that they can't get reshuffled and put on the top. It's possible.
They're not as important.
They're not super urgent.
So I would say at the very least, if we're worried, 1 from here and 1 from
That's
here.
What I was thinking.
And then some from over here where we don't then we
where
don't,
we don't
deal
want
with
to go
those.
Anymore.
Right.
So somebody, Nikki could take care of that one on hers as well. Then it'd be done.
As an action.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's what you should do.
So for this card,
yep. Can you get one of those?
1, 2.
Yep.
And I'd like to point out, we're doing this out of fear, but yeah. I still think it's not necessarily a bad move.
And then I think she should get rid of those
2
over there. I think you should get rid of these so we don't have to even worry about those over there. Because you're going to leave there.
Yeah, I want to leave.
Where is she going to go?
I don't know.
She's going that way?
Yeah, over here.
Because she's red. Maybe she'll go to red. I mean, she's got 2 of
she's
the red.
Gonna, she's
she
going
should,
to.
I
yeah.
think she should actually Wait. Walk, just start to kill and walk down to this way. Because look, we have 5 Arkhams and 5 Dunwiches. We don't even need her power over here to get rid of these.
Yeah.
her special ability is one card fewer, mm-hmm. and if we don't need to use that ability, maybe she should just kind of make her way down here and do a little bookkeeping along the way. Am I crazy?
Maybe let's not even worry about those guys, and she should get down there as quickly as possible. We have the cards in our hands right now to close every gate.
Wow, you're right.
Only in her hands, though.
No.
I have five yellow. You can give, if you can get him one green and she can get one red from any source, then we're good.
We technically even have five red.
I know.
I see what you're saying. Well,
I don't know how exactly we do that and how we get.
She can't use the gate because it's sealed.
No, she can use the bus with red. Red. We don't want to use a red card
right.
That way.
That's the problem.
Yeah. Well, she still has to get two more cultists. So if mm-hmm. you're going to not do those, then pick two someplace
then
else.
Then I would do from down here or something.
Oh, that's right. Do
or
it.
Or here.
Or I kind of think this one is coming up a lot. Or at least one of those.
So there's three.
That's three. One more.
And four from the bus station.
The cafe came up, right?
Yeah, they both came up. Cafe and Historic Inn both came up.
Okay, so they're both equally risky.
Correct. Because they can get reshuffled.
Take the cafe because it's easier for people to travel to the historic.
So there's four.
Okay. The bus station.
Okay. For the card.
And that was no action.
Now
she
my
still
actions.
Has her action. Yes. Right.
Do you want me just to walk four spaces and not worry about cultists so I could get to here, right?
Well, you could also...
1, 2, 3, 4.
Or I walk this way. 1, 2, 3.
I could be wrong. I don't see the value in her being with us right now.
I think you're right. Green and yellow are handled.
Surprisingly
so,
covered.
So she doesn't
need to. What are we
going to
do? You're just hoping she draws a Kingsport card then?
Even if she doesn't, we can eventually get to ourselves.
Yeah, no, he'll pass her that way.
Right.
Or
this is Aaron.
Oh, that's me.
Yeah, and you have two Kingsport cards. So that's four right there.
I thought he was going to use the gate this turn.
I'm planning on that. It seems like the smartest thing to do. But I can still travel quickly. I can get from here to here with no move or with no card.
Right.
Okay. Right? I can meet you here next turn. So yes, mm-hmm. walk down that way. Maybe you kill one of them on the way or maybe not.
Well, that's 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah. Right.
With killing nobody.
Yep. But he said, we should get race kind of to do that.
Yeah, let's race
I'm
to the gates.
I'm surprised we're not further along here.
Well, maybe that'll happen.
Well,
you just said it.
So
I
now,
just jinxed us.
Now, okay. now we're going to need two of those
so
in a row.
So that's my turn.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm turning cards now.
Here we go. Hey!
Check it out.
Saying it changed nothing.
Don't roll the die, is that correct?
Oh, yeah.
Just read me that card again, just make sure.
It's in the discard.
It's just literally like,
don't. Oh, no, here it is.
Yeah.
No sanity roll required to play this card. Until the end of your next turn, players do not need to roll, do not roll sanity rolls.
Okay.
Need not do need sanity not do rolls.
So that no sanity weird. Roll, an awakening, reveal the old one.
It's Atlach Nacha.
Okay.
Nachos?
It's a giant spider guy with a brain. He's gross. Each investigator puts one cultist on their location unless they choose to lose one sanity.
Oh,
you may
on.
Not lose your
hey,
last
man, I'm glad
sanity
we cleaned
token.
Up
all right, well, you don't care, right?
I don't care.
Aaron, you don't care,
no,
right?
No, I don't really.
Lincoln, do you care?
I don't want to roll.
He's about to kill them, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, put one there. That's fine.
Right, it's still one action to clear them all.
I'm assuming we can't go, I choose to roll the die, but I don't have to.
Oh my gosh, sanity rolls.
It seems like a cheat.
No, it's
what?
Lose a token, not roll the
oh,
die.
Oh, lose a token,
okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
Well, here's the thing. These are going to get shuffled right now. This could come up. I can get you a sanity back on my turn, but not until my turn.
Yeah,
let's just do
okay.
it.
What?
You're right.
Why?
Because these are about to be reshuffled.
If you add one there, it could trigger.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because we are going to reveal three now.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I know that blows. I can spin it to give
He's
you all your sanity
on by
if necessary.
A thread.
I know.
It's all right.
On your turn. Not
right,
mine.
Right. Old Mill.
That's
put,
where
Shoggoth is. Yeah.
Old Mill. Oh, no, that's where I'm going. Oh, but I do lose sanity next turn. Dang it.
Is that a gate?
Yes, that's
yes.
where we're headed.
Well, so here's the problem.
Okay.
That Shoggoth is on the gate.
Yes.
So if... In these five cards,
one
of them has a Shoggoth symbol.
Oh yeah,
which
yeah.
I'm pretty sure
I
two
think
of them
at
do.
Least two of them.
Well, there you go. There's two. I just jinxed this by saying that one was
maybe. Maybe I've shuffled correctly. All right, you still need to get your second card. Wait, was it Nikki's turn? Yeah,
it was
your second card.
All right, that's gonna save us all.
Yeah.
Kingsport.
No. Hey, there she can solve
good.
Kingsport.
That's good.
Yeah. All right, here we go. I'm going to regret not playing this now. And then we do three of these.
One, two, three. She can do that.
Three of these?
Yep.
Oh, she can.
Old Mill.
Old Mill River.
Right there.
Wow. It's all right.
It's all right.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, Secret Lodge.
And then
he moves off.
Through the gate.
Through the gate.
An awakening occurs. Reveal another old one.
Azathoth. Remove three cultists from the unused
supply. Oh my gosh.
Oh no. Okay. That's it. It just is a much easier game to lose since we're about to place a third one right now.
Oh my god. But the Shoggoth is gone. That's the good news.
Oh, okay.
That's great.
Sure.
We don't have to defeat it anymore.
Historic,
we did the right thing.
Ooh, yeah. But we will lose at the end of Lincoln's turn unless he, well, he's
going to get rid of a million.
I'm just pointing it out.
Oh, all right. Whew. That was Nikki's turn.
Whew.
I think I might take the three extra actions this
time as
well. Yes, because it doesn't cost
and it still doesn't cost you sanity.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
All right.
All right, Link.
Get some cultists back in the pool.
Okay, so first thing I'm going to do is one.
Yep.
Two.
Yep.
Three.
Yep.
Four.
You used a card for your attraction?
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay,
five.
So five.
And he doesn't have to roll things.
Six is giving me a card.
Six.
Watch this. Actually, six is taking this from me.
Yes.
Okay. And then seven is giving me this card.
And then he can use that for free.
You can use it right now for free without a sanity roll.
Should I just...
It's your turn. You might as well,
you
right?
You need sanity.
But it doesn't cost.
Is, should I go to one, get everybody one, or should I go all the way full?
I think you should go all the way full.
You can't go. He can't go all the way full. Right?
One player can regain full.
One player full or everybody one. I say go full. I'm not worried about my insane side.
I guess I'm not really either. I mean, I'm going to close the game.
Nikki's got three, and you're the one that needs it if more Shoggoths show up.
So I'm done.
Sure.
Spent my three turns. This is now done.
Right.
That was great.
Wait, you spent that too.
Yeah,
you just made three actions.
Yeah. You are.
Wow, he's got no cards.
Okay, that's exciting. That means we did something right.
Yep.
Done. Did which?
These are basically just bus tokens now.
We're two away from losing here, though.
But we're literally three turns away from winning.
All right. And we draw three of these. Is that correct?
Yes.
Here we go. Diner. Oh, just in the nick of time. Cafe.
Oof.
Just in the nick of time.
No, that was fine.
No, we cleared that.
Woods.
Room. Woods.
Just in the nick of time.
Okay, here's my question.
Yep.
Sure.
Dave.
Aaron.
Can you get here to close the gate on your turn? Are you there now?
I'm there now.
Oh, you're there now. We got this in the bag.
Okay.
There's nothing that can go wrong now.
If Evil Spirits comes up.
No, you know what's going to happen? Is I'm going to go through that gate.
Stirs.
I'm going to go through the gate and roll two sanity loss right
oh
now.
Oh my gosh.
All right. You do that.
Or two cultists my location.
Do we want to take that back then as far as this?
No, absolutely not.
Okay. He said the insane side was great, so...
He said that he wanted to play it, even.
If you're going to close the gate, might as well be insane when you do it.
Yeah. But I don't want to trigger one of these.
You're going to go through the gate to here?
Well...
And then try to close it, right?
Yes.
As opposed to one, two, spend a card,
other thing is,
three, and then close
it. I could just do that. It is safer.
Why don't we take the safe route?
All right. So
what's
one,
the fun
two.
In that?
I know, right?
You don't even need to spend any card
three.
To do that.
It costs him at Kingsport.
He does not.
Yes, he does. This is not a bus station.
Only bus station to bus station doesn't cost me a card.
Okay.
One, two, three. And then for four.
For four, I seal a gate.
Yay.
Remove one cultist from every yellow location.
Oh, that's helpful.
Yeah, that is really helpful. That is really, really helpful.
Ta-da!
And you draw two cards.
Do I get a relic?
You get nothing. You get nothing in like
I'm the only one who didn't get a relic.
I only got one out of luck.
I got a green.
Did you not get any relic?
Oh, I got an elder sign.
All right, there you go.
Pick a town. If its gate has been sealed, no new cultist or Shoggoth may be placed in that town.
Ooh.
As a reminder, flip the seal to show the elder
sign. Oh,
there
you go.
Sign.
That's what that's about.
Yeah.
You want to do it in the town you just did?
I don't know. Do I?
You have to roll, though, to do that.
Yeah, I know.
Save it.
I don't. But I'm not going to get another turn. If they both do what they're supposed to do.
Yeah, play it.
Yeah, why not, right?
Okay.
No,
if you put two guys here.
Yeah, it's... No, two is okay.
No, it is. Oh, yeah, right, two is. Do it!
Why not? All right, let's do it.
What are you doing? Which one are you choosing?
Well, it has to be...
Yeah, I do.
It should either be yellow or red.
No, it has to be a closed gate. It has to be yellow or blue.
Oh, well then probably yellow.
All right.
Blue seems not as bad.
Let's do it. Here we go. Nothing happened.
Blank off camera.
So, no. Oh yeah. No Shoggoth or cultist may be placed in that town.
No further ones. Nice.
That's great.
Well, that's
good too, because as those cards come up,
three of them.
Should have thought about that. It's like what cards have been coming
up. It can't go here anyway. It's not.
Yes, blue or yellow are the only choices.
Well, it doesn't matter. Hey, look, Boardwalk. Where we didn't choose. Let's hope these are all blue.
All right.
Shop.
Sure.
Come on, all blue. And the graveyard.
That's where you're going.
That would have been great if they were all blue. It's so dumb.
He's not going there.
All right.
Oh, you're right. Nikki's going there.
Yeah.
The doctor says, for my first action, I shall seal the gate of Arkham.
Yeah.
Skung.
I'm always where the gates are sealed, but I'm not getting to seal them.
Ba-da-boom, ba-da-boom.
That's okay. You saved the world just this turn.
Yeah. I now have four more actions. So why don't I just get rid of stuff?
Like that, that pesky lady sitting there.
Yeah.
Well, that's one.
Lady.
Yeah.
Two, three. Well, I can't really do...
You could go bang, bang. Can you get there? You can't get there.
One.
You can only go here or here with bus.
Let's get the red... Okay.
I'm going to do this. One, two, three, four.
Five. What about five?
No, sorry. One, two, three, four. Oh, you're right. Oh, you're right. One, two, three, four, five.
You seal the gate.
Nothing can come in this.
Nothing goes in there.
One, two.
No,
not
one.
Red.
I'm on two.
Okay.
Two, three.
Four, five? No, there's really nothing.
I don't think it's going to make a difference.
There's really nothing to
do. But just in case it does,
right?
I'm going to go two, three, four, five. I'm just going to go over here.
Sure.
Okay.
Two cards.
Wow, that deck
is really low, too.
Oh, my God.
That's right. If this runs out, we lose.
Yes.
And Kingsport. And three of these, right?
Yep.
All
and
right.
Yellows don't get...
Wow,
we really should have done blue on that. That's not going to matter.
The theater. And the market. All right, Nikki.
Yeah.
That's it, right?
She just walks over.
One, two, three,
three,
four.
Yeah.
Hold on. This is you?
Yeah. Yes.
One, two, three. Mm-hmm. You got to play your cards.
She's got to roll the die.
My eye thing.
Yeah.
Hang on.
What first?
Roll the sanity die here.
Why?
Before you play your card.
Yes.
Okay.
Because when you roll, two cultists would be bad.
Is that legal?
It's just the next one.
Yeah, the next gate.
Yeah.
Yes, so you're going to go one,
legal.
Two.
Absolutely.
Hey, I want to play this card now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Miss one out of six.
Hey.
Oh, at least you see. Wow.
One, two.
Three.
Yeah.
And what do you do for your fourth action?
I would like to seal a gate.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oops, I can't believe we won a pandemic game.
No kidding. On hard.
Yeah.
That was close, though.
It was.
One, two, three more turns.
Well, but two more of these, right?
I understand. I'm just saying there were three. You did not get another turn, no matter. No. Yeah, you got the last turn.
I gotta say, getting the relic that negated the sanity die was
huge. Oh my gosh, that was
great.
Big roll, big turn for us.
And the fact that we had stored up so many relics.
Six relics.
Not that we knew that was coming.
No, it worked out very
smoothly. It just happened to work out.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what do you think, Nikki P?
I liked it. It was fun. It was easy to understand.
Right.
To get the rules and everything. I like the die.
The die's great.
It's really a lot of fun. I wish we had more difficulty, though.
I know, it's funny. We had a fortunate game.
Yeah.
We did play it on the hardest setting, too.
Yes.
I think we were lucky.
Yeah.
We were lucky.
Yeah.
And we've played a lot of pandemic between us.
Yeah, we know the risks.
We do.
Dave is very good at saying it's not a problem and then it becomes a problem. So I mean,
that's the fun, right?
Yeah. It is fun, though. I have to agree. Losing is always hilarious to me.
Yeah,
well, let's
I agree.
See, for the sake of argument, where was the next? This was Lincoln's turn. So it was on Lincoln's turn.
Lincoln's turn.
Okay.
The next evil stirs. And what was the next old one? Just out of curiosity.
Nyarlathotep. Nyarlathotep. You may no longer do the use a gate action. So that doesn't work. You can't travel through the gates.
Some of that is...
only did once, right?
Right. Right.
Some of that is obviously... the randomness of that, too, right? Like, there are a bunch of old ones that didn't come into play.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
One of them was, to walk out of a location with two or more cultists, you must defeat a cultist first.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
So that costs you an action if you're there. You must, all players collectively discard. So in a four-player game, we'd have to get rid of four cards.
Oof.
That could be terrible.
Depending on when that comes up,
that
could have hurt. I mean, that sanity thing came up early enough
mm-hmm.
that we all had a lot of sanity that it didn't really matter.
I like that we did this.
And it's anyway.
Draw the bottom card. Draw the bottom card for the summoning deck. Place the Shoggoth on that location. and then discard in the discard pile, then move each Sargoth one. That would hurt.
That could be bad.
If we had two of them on the board. That's the other thing. These were never much of a problem for us. We got really lucky with them.
Well,
they're so bad that you got to go handle them quickly, right? You can't just leave them wandering around.
Well, one passing through sucked. I mean, that pushed this closer to that card. Yeah.
Here you go. Sealing a gate requires one additional clue card from a connected town. So sealing the red means you need red plus one blue or one yellow.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, that could potentially suck.
A lot of these depend on whether they come up right at the beginning or
whether those would have been worse in our game with less cards, less of these, right?
Draw four cards from the bottom of the deck and add one to each of those locations and then put that in the discard pile. Now, that, in a weird way, could help you.
Yeah, because it makes that
The thing that's the worst in Pandemic is when you have three... Yeah, the last one.
The last one is you lose. Yeah.
Is when you have three or four cards in this deck only.
Right.
And an epidemic happens and you have to shuffle these.
Right. Yes.
And you know
these are
the horrible ones and they're going to come up. Right. We did have that one in this game. And we had essentially the bad thing happen to us, but it just ended up not being as bad as we thought.
Yeah, the timing of these coming out as well is the only rough one was this one. That one being the very first one I thought was going to kill us.
Say what it did.
It says you can only play the relic by the active player. You can't play on anyone else's turn.
That was harsh to come up at
the very beginning.
And I really, that made it very hard for us. But yeah,
it made things harder.
Yeah. Yeah.
What are the other roles?
The other also, because we went as the rules said we went, the randomness of this, if the kill the shark with one action
person
doesn't come out,
right.
Maybe it's not the same, but in theory, the occultist. For an action, move one cultist. For an action, you can move a cultist up to two locations. So you can move these guys.
Oh, that's nice.
And then for two actions, you can move a Shoggoth.
Ooh, wow.
But that can be potentially cool.
Yeah.
When doing the driver, that was the occultist. For the driver, when doing the walk action, you may move up to two locations instead of one. Mm. And you ignore Ithaqua's effect. Did Ithaqua come out? No.
Ithaca.
Ithaca, New York.
Oh, that's the...
To walk... Oh, it's the one where you can't walk out of many cultist locations, but you can drive out.
All right, so when you do a walk, you can move to two instead of one. You can jump two, essentially. Yeah. It means you can't do anything in the one you skip, I assume. And then the magician, you start the game with an unused relic. So you basically start a game with the relic, and your hand limit's eight.
Yeah. Wow, okay, that's not bad. What did you think, Aaron?
I like it quite a bit. I mean, I guess I'm one of those people who feels like I've played enough Pandemic that I don't necessarily need to play it anymore. But that this is fresh enough that I like it again.
There's two new ones this year, too, but go ahead, I'll take it.
Oh, I'm not surprised, but I didn't know that.
But it's interesting, I'll tell
you. There's enough difference and enough theme here that it's fun, even for somebody who's
especially
burned out
on
the original.
We all love Cthulhu stuff.
Yeah, for some people, again, that's a turnoff. Some people are reacted like, oh, great, another Cthulhu game. They're just pasting that on
everything. But it's like zombies and everything else, right?
I think it fits nicely. And
they did a good job of adding that element to this game. I mean, it actually shows what this game can do, right?
Yeah.
There's a lot of
right.
You could probably adapt it to many other kinds of things that would
totally
be
you
super.
Treat this as a base system like Dominion deck building, and then you can put all kinds of things
absolutely.
On top of it. I want to say what my insanity ability was, because I'm sort of curious whether any of the other ones are any good or whether they're all downgrades. I just kind of like I can't do the bus action anymore at all, but I. Once per turn as a free action, I can take a card from the discard pile.
Oh, wow.
A player card that matches the town I'm in. It has to match, but still, that gives me three cards every turn instead of two.
No, that's not bad. And I mean, you do lose an action for that.
Yeah, but
I already said
it's
mine.
Decent.
I just go to four
Yours
actions.
Yours just goes to four actions. And yours, you changes your combat a little bit, but you can...
Right. Well, when I go into a location with no cultists, that was the,
that's
the weird
the bad
part
one,
that would
yeah.
add stuff.
What's yours?
Wow.
Then?
Yeah,
so
mine isn't that bad.
It's not great, though. She still only needs four cards to seal instead of five, but the action of giving a card or taking a card costs two actions.
Ooh, which is important
for
her.
It costs two actions when you participate in a give or take a clue card, so that means it would cost me two as well just to give her a card.
Yeah.
And I didn't finish The Magician. I didn't.
I'm sorry.
Nope. Hand limit's 8. And at any time, you can do the give or take a relic card action for free. Not a player card, but a relic card. Mm-hmm.
What do you think, Dave?
I really liked it, actually. The thing that I liked the most was it didn't feel as crazy as this sounds like, oh, another pandemic knockoff. I actually felt like it was kind of a cool, streamed down, its own thing version of Pandemic. Like, that was nice. You know, part of my problem a lot of times with, like, dice version of card games, for example, of which Pandemic has one that I also happen to really like, but there are a lot of those games where you play them and you think, well, this is good and I like it because it's different, but I'd rather play the original game.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
And I actually like this one. I think the movement is so much easier in this game.
I think that's a huge benefit.
Getting around is significantly easier.
But that makes it more like Arkham, too. I mean, you know, like Arkham Horror.
Yeah.
That movement thing, which I think is thematically more fun with it. You know, not that they're, like, modeling it after that, but clearly they are modeling some of this after Arkham Horror, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right. I do agree with Nikki to a certain extent.
I'm disappointed that it
was I gotta be honest with you. I feel like I missed a rule somewhere.
I think
that's how I feel right now.
You guys are wrong. It was not easy.
No, it wasn't. We did very well.
We're just really good.
And we were lucky. We were both.
And we do know. What
so
we're
doing. You got to be lucky and good to win a lot of things.
That's true.
So I think a lot of people who just pulled this out of the box might remember back when Pandemic came out and people said, we've lost 10 times in a row.
Right.
This game is broken on the regular difficulty level.
That's true. I definitely have some friends who played it at the expert level and beat it every time. And by the way, I don't know how they do that.
Okay.
That game at the hardest setting is still ridiculously hard to me.
Yeah, this was submitted, I guess, as a design to Z-Man. And I think Matt Leacock worked on it, but he also did another pandemic this year called Pandemic Iberia, and it takes place in the 1800s, and you're like building railroads, and you're getting around with rail. It's like it sounds really, really great. It's another take on it, and Matt Leacock worked on that as well with a designer from Spain, I believe.
Mm. Oh.
So, you know, it's exciting to see that they're doing... To me, that they're doing more with this, because when I, in my head, I was developing a War on Terror game back in the day before this came out. And when I, you know, it was just germinating, right? And I wasn't even sure if I liked that theme. But when I played Pandemic, I'm like, oh my God, this does exactly what I want, what I was thinking. Because Sleeper Cells and all that stuff, right?
Yeah.
It did everything that I thought was spectacular about that and was... just amazing. And this guy has continued to like make this. So now that game could exist. He could do some.
Sure.
Hey, Matt, by the way, you can do a War on Terror game. I already told him about that. But it's just really cool that it's got that deck mechanism.
Yeah.
While not as horrifying in this game for us.
Yeah.
Just in this game. But that's the most horrifying thing about playing Pandemic.
Oh, yeah.
Flipping those things over is just like, how horrible can this possibly be?
I can't remember. I feel like these numbers ramp up more in Pandemic. Like, they go 4-2s.
I think you're right.
I think Pandemic is like
2-2-3-3-4-4, something like that. Yeah.
Mm.
I believe you're right.
But this is a lot of fun.
But I'm sure they did all the math, and that's as fast as this can ramp.
These games are being designed also by other people. I think that's part of
that
it.
That they're all open to that is awesome.
Yeah,
right?
There's something really cool
Matt
about
is
that.
That cool about it. Because I know there's some designers that don't like
that. I played
that.
Many versions of Settlers, and there are some that I really like, but I feel like I'm probably wrong, but weren't most of them Klaus Toiber?
I think he does everything.
I mean, I really like, for example, Settlers of the Stone Age. That was really good. Mm-hmm. But I can't even remember the name of some of the other ones. The Egyptian one,
Pandemic Keops. Legacy came about, I believe, because...
Zarahemla.
Because Rob Davial contacted Matt. So he had that idea, too. Mm. So Matt obviously realizes that, you know, there's fun to be had for him in doing that kind of stuff, right? Doing the developing with somebody
else. Don't get me wrong. There's nothing wrong with the other way.
Of course.
With the designer doing another one and another one.
But these come out of, like, potentially left field for the guy, right?
What's not, because you're getting another brain kind of thinking about it. It's potential.
Yeah,
it's amazing. It's bizarre, but it's been, like, a couple years of Pandemic,
you know, because Tom Lehman did the dice game with him, did he
right.
not?
Yeah, I think so.
So it's like, it's that pattern had been already, they were establishing that, and Matt is obviously one of those guys that maybe really likes the, potentially to do that, you know?
Yeah.
But yeah, because we've got Matt Tom Lehman, Rob Daviau, and then two guys I don't know. And this is Chuck Yager, I think is his name.
The airplane pilot?
The artist?
Yeah, no, it's not. Well, here's probably Yager. It's Y-A-G-E-R. Mm. But yeah, it's so cool. It's really neat that they did this.
Yeah. I wanted to agree with you two. You kind of touched on it, that it's a really good combination of Arkham Horror and the pandemic mechanism. I didn't feel like I was playing just
Pandemic
with the theme slapped on top of it. I felt like I was playing an Arkham Horror game.
Yeah, it definitely.
So
it changes the nature of. I mean, the changes they made it different enough. Like it's what Dave was saying.
So yeah.
It's enough that it doesn't feel exactly like Pandemic, right? You're not. It has those elements, but it's not Pandemic in that regard.
It also fits well with this kind of graphic art. This kind of art design, like. I don't mind in Pandemic that the diseases are cubes, because what are diseases going to look like? I wouldn't want weird little amoeba blobs. Yeah.
But they do if you buy the
you can upgrade to that.
They'd be cute and everything.
I would love those.
They'd be cute and everything, but I don't need them. But I like that these are figures.
Yeah, me too.
I feel like I'm actually fighting a bunch of people.
Right.
Just because they're actual figures.
Yeah. Figures.
Although I do like how we do tower over.
I know.
You cultists.
Kick them around.
Oops. Number one.
All right.
Numbered. Oh, in case you can't figure out who you are.
Oh, wow. Okay.
That's so great. Number two.
No, that can't be, is it?
Yeah.
No,
they're all numbered.
But are the cards numbered?
No.
Then why? What point are they?
Yeah.
That's silly.
No, fair enough. Maybe it's listed in the book. Like, this one is number one.
Interesting. They did do a new Pandemic this year as well for expansion for The Cure, the
dice game.
Yeah, that we've played already.
That's cool.
Well, thanks for teaching us, Dave.
You're welcome, Lincoln. And others. Doctor has a straw hat. Is that him?
That's him.
Straw hat.
I get bowler.
Oh, but look at that.
It's in the 1920s. We all have hats.
I almost want to be the magician just because I can see it easier.
Right.
As a token.
Yeah.
All right. And then before we do that.
Is there anybody who doesn't have a hat? There's not. Everybody. It's the 1920s. Everybody has a hat.
Come on. Polite society. They wear hats.
I know.
What should they come off when they go in church?
Nikki Detective.
I was hoping ties would go out of fashion at some point. Maybe in my lifetime.
No, they're going to have two at some point here.
Yeah.
2015, I thought they'd have, but they don't.